The banners said, "Don't trade away our lives, hands off our medicine." At the beginning of March, 3,000 people living with HIV from across Asia protested in the streets of New Delhi to defend their right to antiretroviral treatment.
It's a pity that we have to come out in the streets, travel such long distances, and really come out on the streets at this time of in the 21st century, in that sense. In 2011, we have to hit the streets to demand for treatment or to demand for life, our right to live.
It's generic medicines that are at stake. AIDS drugs in particular, but medicines for other illnesses like tuberculosis and malaria too. India is the world's largest producer of low-cost generic medicines, which are used extensively in developing countries. Negotiations currently taking place with the European Union could restrict access to these life-saving medicines.
The context of this free trade agreement has not been publicly disclosed. In this agreement, the generic medicines, the medicines produced in India for HIV and cancer patients at cheaper rates, will somehow stop being manufactured. It's to support this cause that everyone living with HIV and their supporters have assembled to protest and to reach out to the Indian government, media and parliament so that they at least think twice before they make any significant decisions.
Intellectual property provisions in the free trade agreement, particularly the data exclusivity measure, would prevent Indian manufacturers from producing generic medicines from molecules that are already off patent or from molecules that don't even merit one. Millions of sick people in developing countries fear they will no longer have access to treatment, turning the clock back 10 years.